Gas. Gospel at his own with VJ Saros. And today with me in the house, I have with me a well-known artist that you call your Apala man. I call him Yomi Apala, but today you're gonna know his real name. You're welcome, bro.
Oh, thank you.
Wow. No wonder we call that the Yomi
boy. It's a pleasure.
Oruko yefa wala lele kore.
Oruko mini Yomi Olabisi, popularly known as Yomi Apala.
Yomi Apala.
Yes.
How do you discover that name?
Yomi Apala, actually. I can remember as way back as 2014 when we started this music. When we released the album, you know, the first album I released then, I called it New System Apala Gospel.
Okay.
So the acceptability of the work and being the first work, you know, people were so excited about the work and they were being blessed. That's why they changed the name to Yomi Apala. So before you know it, people are calling me Yomi Apala instead of the Yomi Olabisi. Delete the Olabisi.
So, Apala. So
that's why Yomi Apala, Yomi Apala.
That means you too much to pay and you call it for a little
bit. And become a full amino record.
When did you start this music career?
Yes, I can say I started
officially
2014. This is what I have to do. This is my life.
Okay.
This is what I'm made for. So I was made for this. Okay. So no jacking back to 2014.
Okay. So since 2014.
Yes.
To the 2019.
Yeah.
And how has been the journey?
The journey has been, you know, to the glory of God.
Oh, don't go.
Because you couldn't go.
So how was it?
The journey has been full of, you know, valleys, you know, ups and downs.
But to the glory of God.
But to the glory of God, we praise God.
Okay, so since 2014.
Yes.
To the 2019.
Yeah.
How many albums have you released? Or let's say tracks.
Tracks, we have released 3 singles. At the Goshi, Big D, Thanks in Trillions. I have done 3 studio albums. The first album is because it was just like a child's play then. But still yet, if you bring that today, people still appreciate it.
Mm.
So counting it like that is 3 albums like that. Easter Sunday,
right.
I'm going to release a musical video, just a studio session.
All right.
So, and that. Let's keep waiting for that.
How do you get your inspiration?
Inspiration, Apala.
just listen to some music. You know, like, as in, let me just, because there's one of your music that there's someone that spoke about it. It's like in a line of Baba, those old men, Baba.
Yeah.
Do you listen to their music?
Okay, I have made a lot of research about Apala music.
Mm.
And about all this, I started from all these stuff that I've heard about. And what are the encompassment of the music? You know, each music have a kind of principle.
Of course.
So I know the principle, the rule that bind it. So I have taken my time to make wide research. In fact, there was a time I went to meet all these people that play shekere, konkon, at all these occasions. So I went to meet them also. You know. Drink tap from their well of knowledge. Mm. The spirit has been in me. That Apala spirit. So there's no half.
So, but
most time when I it's very funny that I receive most songs during my sleep. Nigada should joba o. Hey, Arubu Ojo, koni bi mo. Abalogun Orun, Buhari lo yan minister.
Okay. So, how do you combine those stuff?
So the thing is that as a songwriter. You have to be open-minded.
Mm.
You have to listen to a lot of things people are saying here and there, you know.
That means you
you have to be current.
You sing on your environment stuff.
Yes, most times I sing on environment and majorly I sing with the Bible. So I can just pick up a verse in the Bible like this and you know
it's very easy. Take it to Apala way. Mm.
So like that and you know we just bless God for the inspiration.
When you started this music career,
yeah.
Is it acceptable by family members or your
parents? No, it's not acceptable. My parents, actually my mom, the support was not there initially. You know, like I studied civil engineering in school, so they just want me to be a renowned engineer.
Mm-hmm.
She was like, you know, it's not easy now.
Serious.
spending 5 years in the university, she expects that you come out, you go and get a work, maybe like Shell or some or NAPC, and you'll be collecting money. Right. She gets, so it was not acceptable.
So that's the expectation.
That's the expectation.
So now seeing you in this music.
In this music, that, engineering and music.
You know Shomai.
You know Shomai, no? But with time, it's time. When she also begins to see the results, and it comes to a point that also when she's going out, people are like, wow, money. So when it's reached that point, she was like, wow, I think there's a future in this. So they have to calm down. And you know, they're like, in gospel music, you don't really, like, they're like, it's not easy to make money there. And I do say something, that it's not even everyone in secular music that is making money.
Of course.
So what even I'm in secular music, I'm part of those that are not making the money. So what difference does this make?
It's acceptable.
Yeah, it's acceptable by them now.
Who's your producer?
I have a producer. Adeyane Baba. That's my producer, and we have been, you know, we work together. We have been making a lot of sounds together for so long. I feel so much humbled. Let me say that.
Mm-hmm.
And I just feel humbled. You know that. You know, I'm just like, wow. It's just grace of God. I don't know. I just say something. It's not talent. It's not, you know, it's not psychology. It's not that you know how to do this. It is just that you are grace carrier. That's just it.
Just it. Grace.
Just grace.
All right. You. Those challenges since 2014. I think you have challenges now.
Lot of.
just let's and how you know, overcome them.
There have been many days when the going gets so tough. One of the challenges I can remember was a day I went to minister somewhere. I think that was 2014 or so. Yeah, like as we finished ministry on the stage, and you know, people were blessed in that church, very large crowd, like about 1-5 people. You know, the man of God just came on the podium and just try to rubbish everything we have done. Like, wow, what kind of song is this in the church? Come. You know,
people. I don't feel it.
But that day, you know, I didn't feel so much bad because I'm prepared for something like that. But when I got home that day, I felt so disturbed that, wow, am I sure I'm gonna do this thing? Let every man abide in the same calling when he's called. But that was the verse of the Bible that the Lord used to console me then, as you just have to abide by this. It will work. Well, and I just decided that whether this even work or not, I don't care again. I just have to do this.
Alright. Yeah. Alright. Since with Yomi Apala, Yomi Olabisi, what's your hobby?
My hobby is traveling. I love adventure. Go, you know, if not for the grace of God that captured me, I'm someone that I maybe by now you'd have seen me in a party. You know, I love adventure. You know, go to cinema, go away for like 2 months, go on a break. I love adventures. I'm an adventurous person, but I don't have time for it.
Yeah.
But if I have the time, you know, I just love it.
So should we pick traveling?
Traveling, let's say traveling. That's my idea. I think
it's already happening. There's something we've seen on social media now that you live in Ibadan, something like that.
Yeah.
What about that?
Mega concert coming up in Ibadan this year. We are bringing.
Are you traveling to Ibadan?
We are taking a concert to Ibadan this year.
Alright.
We target Yomi Olabisi live on stage Ibadan. It's going to be a...
Well, you're based in Ogbomosho. How would that be possible?
Yes, I'm based in Ogbomosho, but you know, as a music minister, we are not restricted to a point. So God has given us the mandate to take this event to Ibadan.
Right.
So it's going to come up on July 21st, 2019. We have the ministers like Shemwele Jesu, Papa Tomichi is coming. We have Dot Vocals and a host of other music ministers.
Let people know your social media handle now.
Yeah, on Instagram and on Facebook, you can connect with me, Yomi Olabisi. On Twitter at Yomi Olabisi. On YouTube too, you can watch my videos.
So,
and subscribe to my channel, Yomi Olabisi. Contact me on 081-3060-8553.
Just give the youth out there a word of advice.
My advice for the youth is that Igbara Labura and Nikon Bushango Igberon. So whatever we want to do, let's be focused. Time is just ticking every day.
Time no wish for anybody.
Yeah.
Alright, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode live interview with Yomi Olabisi. My name is VJ Sados. Thanks for watching this episode. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and this episode is sponsored by AK Samtech. Bye.